point of the week goes to Katie Lorraine, radical subversive self-love, Cristen Conger nails it again. I will love me even though society tells me not to. And Katie, I'm gonna love you too. Unless that's a little creepy, because I don't know you. And I'm really dropping the L-bomb fast. This week on Stuff Mom Never Told You, I kick things off with a question that I have been asked a lot and have honestly kind of avoided answering, which is, why do gay men lisp? Well, it's just a sibilant S. It's not a lisp. Then I asked a very important question. Why do we call vulvas vaginas? Finally, I offered up some historical Halloween costume ideas because, people, Halloween is coming up. What are you gonna be? I am going to be Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Now time for Ask Cristen. First of all, thanks to everybody who watched and commented on last week's Ask Cristen video all about the fat guy stigma. Megas Sartori had this to say. Fat men have the dubious distinction of understanding what street harassment is like for women. How many times has someone screamed, "Run, fatty," from the window of a pickup truck? I don't ride bikes anymore, the one exercise I truly enjoy, because I know every single person I pass will be silently thinking of the circus bear on a bicycle, and some will say it. We really need to stop being such ding-dongs to each other. Hi, I'm Cristen. I'm eloquent. Julie Lingso said, the only way to uproot the fat stigma is to talk about it. Emphasize how fat and skinny people are both just people. Weight isn't an identity, it's the amount of gooey stuff between your skin and bones. I like the gooey stuff between your skin and bones, Julie, and I'm referring to your brain. Now to this week's Ask Cristen question from Sierra G. Why do girls wear makeup? This whole topic ties in really well to the video I did a few weeks ago. How do I learn to love my butterface? And a lot of comments and suggestions focused on makeup, of learning how to find the makeup that worked the best and was most flattering for this girl's face. So as someone who researches, writes, and talks a lot about things like feminism, gender differences, the cultural history of femininity, and what all that means, I think a lot about my own makeup practice. I rarely leave the house without at least probably some mascara on. Now, for instance, I have slathered my face in layers of makeup, believe it or not. As I've mentioned before on the show, my history with makeup goes all the way back to when I was a girl.
When I was 12, what did I get for my birthday? Not a pony, not a bicycle, not even tickets to go see NSYNC. I got a Mary Kay makeup consultation.
I was essentially raised with the expectation that at one point, the Mary Kay makeup consultant would come over to our house and she would show me how to put on my eyeshadow and I would finally be a woman. The cosmetics industry in the United States alone is worth $50 billion. They've gotten really good at selling us products that they promise will revolutionize. That's a highlighter. That's not a lipstick. But let's just say, that will revolutionize your face. Those are probably some of the most common explanations that we hear for why women wear makeup. We're told to, whether by cosmetics companies or the women around us. Let's move away from the social stuff and get more into the science. Makeup is useful in the sense of concealing flaws, enhancing symmetry, and also exaggerating features like the whiteness of our eyes and the redness of our lips. Evolutionary biology, classic signals of female sexual health and fertility.
You wanna go out?
You're ready.
Red carpet ready?
Along those same lines, a 2008 study in the Journal of Cosmetic Science divided makeup wearing women into camouflage and seduction camps. Now there was also a 2011 study out of the University of Basque which concluded that women wear makeup to provide a quote, relief from dissatisfaction. We use these tools to give ourselves a confidence boost and make us feel more prepared to put our face forward into the world.
I am a woman. Hear me roar.
A lot of girls and women wear makeup because we believe that it will make us more attractive to other people. Whether we're talking about just attractive in the sense of looking friendlier and more competent and more approachable, perhaps in the workplace, or attractive in the sense of, hubba hubba, I can't wait to get your number and really respectfully approach you and ask you on a date. In a nutshell, the reason girls wear makeup serves both an internal and external purpose. It seems seems that we put on our makeup to give ourselves that psychological jolt of self-confidence, perhaps, of feeling better camouflaged or more seductive. Also, it serves the external purpose of us thinking that we are fulfilling this beauty standard out in the world. Makeup is a very powerful tool. And sometimes, does it keep us self-objectifying ourselves? Does it keep us somewhat in this double bind? Does it perpetuate a beauty myth? Absolutely. But do I personally have any plans to stop wearing makeup? No. I think it makes my face more palatable for the viewer, and that also is reflective in how kind the comments tend to be. And also just in my day-to-day, if I put on mascara, I don't feel like that is sacrificing part of myself for it. I think it's important to remember the power of makeup as it relates to gender play and gender performance. I have a feeling that trans viewers probably have a lot to say about makeup as well. Now I want to hear from you. Do you wear makeup? Why or why not? Let me know in the comments below. And as always, ask me your questions so I can give you some answers.